Iran's hardline president Ebrahim Raisi has been killed in a helicopter crash. Raisi and his foreign minister were returning from a visit to the border with Azerbaijan. Their chopper crashed while crossing a mountain terrain in heavy fog. Rescue teams finally found the charred remains of the chopper and confirmed that there were no survivors. As Iran grapples with the loss of its president, there is uncertainty over the future of the nation, with its implications that could reverberate across the Middle East. Given the historical animosity between Iran and Israel, there is speculation of Tel Aviv's hand in the chopper crash. This theory gains traction after recent escalations in tensions. In April, Israel assassinated a top Iranian general in Damascus. Iran responded with an unprecedented barrage of missile strikes. It was the first time that Iran had directly struck Israeli territory. Israel's intelligence agency, the Mossad, is known for its operations against Iran, including the killing of several nuclear scientists. But Israel has denied any involvement in the chopper crash, which killed Raisi. Israel's strategy has been to target military and nuclear sites, not high-profile politicians. Israel has never gone so far as to assassinate a head of state, which would be seen as an act of war, and invite the fiercest response yet from Iran. Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei has assured that business of Iran's government will continue no matter what. Under the Iranian constitution, the country's first vice president, Mohammad Mukhber, has taken over with Khamenei's assent. But a new presidential election will be called within the next 50 days. And there is no shortage of powerful officials who have been waiting for an opportunity like this to move further up the regime's power structure. But what presents a further challenge to Khamenei is the fact that a hardliner like Raisi was viewed as his protege, someone who would replace the 85-year-old leader after his death or resignation. Khamenei expressed grief over the bitter news of the martyrdom of the people's president. With Raisi's death, the only other person so far suggested has been Mujtaba Khamenei, the 55-year-old son of the supreme leader. The sudden demise of Raisi could disrupt the balance of power within Iran and well beyond. For the past 7 months, Israel has waged a war in Gaza that was triggered by a Hamas attack on Israeli cities. Iran has been repeatedly accused of backing Hamas and opening multiple fronts against Israel through proxies like the Hezbollah in Lebanon and the Houthis in the Red Sea. Since the start of the war, Iran's leaders have expressed solidarity with the Palestinians. Iran views itself as the chief patron of Palestinian resistance to Israeli rule. Raisi had been vocal about his criticism for Israel, saying the Zionist Israeli regime has been committing oppression against the people of Palestine for 75 years. Israel has, of course, long viewed Iran as its greatest threat because of Tehran's controversial nuclear program, its ballistic missiles, and its support for armed groups sworn to Israel's destruction. Against this heavy backdrop, the helicopter crash that killed the Iranian president is bound to spark a wave of speculation. And anything that points to foul play may escalate tensions in the already sensitive region.